Welcome to Feed Dump, where we are the cream of the crop. Yes, we're YouTube comments. I am Did He Died? And joining me this week is that guy.
Fuck this double asshole ass.
And that other guy.
First.
We are truly the intellectual champions of our generation. From the Ruining Everything You Love and Hold Dear file, scientists from Birmingham and Oxford University have discovered that laughter is not the best medicine. It's actually really, really bad for you.
Boy, are you watching the right show.
So not only now are the direct causes of happiness, such as red meat, sugar, carbs, salt, chocolate, and sex, bad for you, but even the mirth itself is now toxic.
Well, it's not technically toxic, but according to researchers at these universities who studied medical records going all the way back to 1946, apparently a loud guffaw can cause heart rupture, torn gullets, and incontinence. And the sharp inhalation of breath that you get when you're laughing can trigger asthma attacks or cause objects to be lodged inside you. So they recommend never laughing.
Our name is a killing word.
Feedump!
As it turns out, our LD50 is ironically depressingly high. LD50 is a weight-by-weight concentration of a substance necessary to kill 50% of laboratory animals.
Ha! Uh-oh.
Still looking for a gift for that hard-to-please Slipknot fan or junior goth on your list? Why not spend $200 to sponsor a 19th century skull at a Philadelphia museum?
Oh, a sculpture. You shouldn't have.
I was asked not to participate in Christmas anymore after I did the same thing with a Cambodian knockoff of this present.
This Christmas season, don't be a bonehead. Sponsor a bonehead.
Thanks a lot. I'm naming him after you.
So what exactly do you mean by sponsor? 200 bucks seems pretty cheap for the Damien Hirst treatment.
What are we talking here? Like a polishing, a buffing, a cleaning, a mani-pedi, a grill?
No. According to the Mutter Museum of the College of Physicians of Philadelphia, the skulls have been on display for more than 100 years, and all the vibrations are causing their teeth to loosen and fall out and crack.
So, grills.
Italian police have arrested 4 mobsters in Naples who were running an extortion ring by forcing shop owners to buy overpriced poinsettias.
Really? You used to wake up in bed with a horse head, and now you're getting soaked on the houseplant that you guilted into buying every year?
Non avertimor, resta sul mio cuore.
But seriously, how overpriced are we talking?
Turns out a lot. For the past 3 years, the mobsters were running this racket, and they were selling these poinsettias for over 100 euro. And if they didn't buy, their businesses would be mysteriously vandalized.
With poinsettias?
They were also intimidated.
With poinsettias?
No, with threats.
Sounds like Christmas.
A Florida man has been slapped with a ticket and a fine after trying to trade what for a 12-pack of beer at a local convenience store.
I got most of a baby right here. It's still good, I swear.
A 6-pack of beer?
Straight up poinsettias.
I got this skull with a grill.
Are you guys just going back through the entire episode now?
First!
I think we may have hurt someone.
No, it was an alligator. He tried to trade a 4-foot-long live alligator for beer. But it doesn't quite seem as interesting now, does it?
Wow, that guy sucks.
Mm-hmm. And with that, I'm disabling comments and bringing this video to a close. But remember, there may be better sources for news, but they don't have this dainty hat, which is an antique, and is probably filled with bugs. Hooray!